While platonic relationships are valuable to us as adults, there may be times when they prove to be toxic and downright overwhelming. My next guest is a marriage and family therapist, and today we'll discuss the therapeutic release of toxic female relationships.
I am marriage and family therapist Gerreka Gilliam, and you are watching The Chundria Show.
Gerreka Gilliam, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
How are you?
You know, busy.
Busy is good.
Yes.
Okay, let's dive right on in.
Okay.
Tell me about yourself and your life as a marriage and family therapist and what inspired your mission to serve.
Okay, yes. So I've been a marriage and family therapist for, I want to say, about 2 years now. I graduated in 2018, and the reason why I went is because I found that people would always come and talk to me about like their problems, their issues, whatever may be going on. And so when my dad passed away, I saw that like no one was going to counseling, but we were all hurting in different ways. And so I said, if I was going to go to grad school for anything, what would it really be? And that's when I fell into clinical psychology. And through that, I just really wanted to kind of break the stigma of mental illness. And I also wanted to encourage my family to go and seek counseling as well, because like I said, we were all hurting in different ways.
I love that. I love where your heart is. How do you encourage women with toxic female friends to find solace? How do you encourage women to make that a part of their self-care?
I have to ask them first, like, how does this friendship benefit you? And people think that that's harsh, but
but it shouldn't be.
It shouldn't, and it's your mental stability, right? So you have to ask yourself, how does this person value my life? And look at the last three encounters and see, you know what? How did I feel when I was with them? Did I feel encouraged? Was I sad? Was I irritated? Was I annoyed? Because you have to be mindful of your space and the energy that you keep around you, because you're only as good as your circle. So let's say that friend is like, oh man, every time I'm with her, she's drunk, or every time I'm with her, she's cussing, or there's always some drama, or there's a woe is me. And it's every time, and she's not feeding into the other friend, then that's key signs that it might be time to release that relationship, because it can be toxic. People don't really know, but it should be an exchange, you know? And that exchange doesn't have to be all the time, but for the most part, it should be some balance to that.
It should be reciprocal.
Mm-hmm.
And it's okay, though, if it's not reciprocated. That's a part, I love that that's a part of your self-care.
Oh, for sure.
That's not working.
Like, what do you mean?
In the new year. I'm not, can't deal with that. As a professional therapist, where do you draw the line in the sand between repairing the issues or ending things amicably?
I think you have to have real conversations. And so, like, you can tell someone, hey, this is bothering me. And then you give them a chance to fix it, right? So I am a firm believer of you have to teach people how to treat you. You have to. And so if I say, hey, this is something that is bothering me, it's hurting me, and they get defensive or they're not able to, you know, accept it at that time, it's okay. I have to take a step back and give space. I have done that so many times, even like childhood friends, because you know, you grow apart. And so I've literally have to told them, like, I told them the reason, you know, why we're taking space.
That's really brave of you to do.
Yeah.
A lot of times we don't find it necessary to do.
Oh, absolutely.
We don't want to do, like, I'm just too much. I'm done, bye.
Yeah, I just feel like you have to, when you have longevity there, you have to really see, like, is this something that is worth fighting for?